That's what she did. But she enjoys her job, which does all the time. I was an Irish people can't believe you do that. And I was just like, I'm waiting for the city. That's what I know. I said, I was trying to make every excuse in the world. She said, well, I just thought you did it for my father to come. I thought, well, man, you have just given me the hit in the stomach.
You gotta get in there. You gotta get in.
I don't know.
How are you?
Mr. Limbaugh, this is my dad.
Good evening. We will go ahead and call this meeting to order. Okay, I thought there was something. Did I remember there was something that broadcast first? Or
yeah, we're
okay,
ready,
I call for it.
We're ready, Brian. Go launch.
Thank you. Now, if you will, stand with me, and before we have the invocation, what I'd like to do is have a moment of silence for our former Mayor Barry McCulley. As some of you know, he passed away on February the 3rd, I think I'm correct. And since this is our first meeting, just bow your head with me for just a second. Thank you very much. We also have with us Buddy Scales, who is not only the minister of music for the First Baptist Church of Rimlap, but the father of our own Melody Salter. And we are so happy to have you with us, Buddy. And if you'll go ahead and handle the invocation, then the Pledge of Allegiance will follow.
Okay. Thank you all, first of all, for the opportunity to come and participate with you this evening. Let's go and pray with me as we pray. Our most gracious and heavenly Father, eternal God, our Savior and our Redeemer. First of all, we do lift up the McCulley family to you, Lord, knowing that only through you, through your peace and through your comfort, Lord, and your guidance and strength, that this family will be able to proceed ahead in the days, Lord, as they call upon your name, Lord, to sustain them. Lord, thank you for this opportunity to live in this great nation, and for this state of Alabama and all the cities that comprise this state, and especially the city of Homewood. Lord, we lift up the mayor, council members, the city officials that have gathered here tonight to discuss the city's business. Lord, we lift them up to you, ask for guidance and direction as they go over the agenda, Lord, that we pray over all the topics. And we just pray, Lord, that they'll have the confidence and understanding of the issues, and if there are any disagreements, Lord, we pray that there will be a harmonious relationship of all here in a Christ-like manner. And Lord, we ask as we leave this place, Lord, for safety and return in our homes. And thank you again, Lord, for the opportunity we have for the mercy to come before you with a thanksgiving heart for all the blessings and mercy you bestow upon us daily. In Jesus' precious name, we pray this. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you so much, sir. All right, if we could have roll call, Ms. Salter.
Yes, sir. Mr. Gwaltney?
Here.
Mr. Thames?
Here.
Mr. Higginbotham?
Here.
Mr. Wolverton? Mr. McCluskey?
Here.
Mr. Jones?
Here.
Mrs. Smith?
Here.
Mr. Wyatt?
Here.
Mrs. Andress?
Here.
Mr. Wright?
Here.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Here. So we have a quorum. And the next item of business would be a reading of the minutes from the council meeting of January the 9th, 2017. And the chair would welcome a motion to dispense of reading and approve of said minutes.
Move. So second. Moved.
Motion from Mr. Jones, second from Mr. Gwaltney. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? And that is unanimous. All right. Also, the minutes of the January 23rd, 2017. And again, the chair would welcome a motion for dispensing of reading those and approval of said minutes.
So moved.
Motion from Ms. Smith, second from?
Second.
Second from Mr. Higginbotham. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? And that too is unanimous. Okay, we have one board appointment and one board vacancy. And let me announce the vacancy. We have an at-large seat on the HDRA, IDB, CDA combined boards. And what I'd like to do is to announce that's open tonight, and we will close it on February 27th. So we'll have it open for 2 weeks. Okay? And this is the seat currently held by, help me, Ms. Salter.
I believe it was Mr. Stephen Johnson.
Stephen Johnson. Okay. Thank you very much. All right. At this point, we have a couple of additions to the agenda. Both are committee.
Mr. President. Ward 1 would like to make an appointment for our vacant position.
Good. Go ahead.
We would like to appoint Jeremy Love to the Municipal Housing Code Abatement Board.
Second.
All right, so we have a motion for Mr. Gwaltney, a second for Mr. Thames. Do we, again, the name is?
Jeremy Love.
Any further questions or discussion about this? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? And that is unanimous. And Ms. Salter, if you'll let him know, we appreciate it. I apologize for that. All right, next, additions to the agenda. Both are committee referral. First is 1802-17, which is a request to fund Service First Landscaping as per prior agreement. This will be referred to finance, requested by myself. Then 1902-17, request to fund and authorize the mayor to sign a phase four mitigation study related to the West Homewood odors, requested by Walter Jones, and again, assigned to our finance committee. And those are the two items. Are there any other items? If there are not, chair would welcome a motion for approval of the amended agenda.
So moved.
All right, motion from Mr. Higginbotham, second from Mr. McCluskey. With no further discussion, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? That is unanimous. All right, we have no consent agenda items tonight. So we're going to take an item out of order here, if we can. 1301-17, which is on page 2, a request for consideration to declare property at 1900 26th Avenue South surplus property and for sale. Greg Cobb, our BEZ department. I will ask for either a report from finance or Mr. Cobb, if you can come forward, or Mr. Jones?
Sure. The Finance Committee met on February the 6th and voted 4-0 to send this item back to the full council without recommendation pending an appraisal of the property. Mr. Higginbotham made that motion. Mr. Thames seconded it. And I believe we have the appraisal back, and Kendrick or?
Yes, sir. As a result of the appraisal, in my conversation with you, I contacted the party that was interested in purchasing a property, sent them the appraisal, and they've agreed, as I understand it, to pay the appraisal price of $10,000.
All right.
So the resolution, the ordinance would.
Yes, sir, if we could have the reading.
Sure. It's hereby declared and established that the following described property is no longer needed for municipal purposes and is declared surplus property. Has a legal description. The street address is 1900 22nd Avenue South, Homewood 35209. Whereas the clerk is to take any action necessary to advertise the property for sale. B, that Section 3, the mayor is authorized and directed to dispose of the property described in Section 1 by sale to Mason Realty LLC and Alabama Limited Corporation for $10,000.
All right, thank you, Mr. Kendrick. Chair would welcome a motion and a second for unanimous consent. Motion from Ms. Smith, second from?
Second.
Second from Mr. Thames. All right, roll call. Ms. Salter.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham?
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andrus?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. All right, so this will be ordinance 20, am I reading this right, 2647?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
And I would, Mr. President, I would move to approve ordinance 2647.
All right, we have a motion from Mr. Jones. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second from Mr. McCluskey. Roll call, Ms. Salter.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Wolverton, Mr. Higginbotham?
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey?
Wait a minute, Mr. Wolverton's here.
Oh, Mr. Wolverton, I'm sorry. Yes. Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andrus?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. So 2647 passes 11-0. All right, we'll go back to 04-12-16, request for consideration of Central Avenue parking. Report from finance, Mr. Jones.
Yes, sir. The committee met, voted 4-0 to recommending funding the traffic study not to exceed $5,000 from engineering services. And we're amending the 16-17 general fund budget for that expenditure and carried the item over for further work. We've got some more work to do on that item, but that's our initial recommendation.
All right, thank you, sir. So therefore, we have a motion from Finance. Is there any other questions or discussion?
Yeah, Chet, make sure I understand. So this is separate and apart from our overall planning study? Okay.
Was this what we discussed with Caliper last week?
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
That's right. It's a very exciting project. It's going to add lots of parking spots and just a general traffic calming within Central. So lots of really exciting things that are happening. We just can't do all of it at one time. It's going to be in phases, so this is really the first part to make sure we don't have any sight line distance issues with the parking spots, et cetera.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Sure.
All right, any other comments? There be none. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? That is unanimous, and that's Resolution 1723. We move on to 020117, request for consideration to work in the city right-of-way for Barber Dairy at 126 Barber Court for the proposed installation of a poured-in-place concrete storm sewer control box pending indemnification agreement requested by Dean Foods, Wynn Eccles, Engineers of the South, Vanessa McGrath, our BEZ department. This was carried over from 123 of 17. We still need a report from special issues.
Yes, the committee met on February 6th, and after seeing the plans from Engineers of the South, Mr. Higginbotham made a motion to recommend approving them to work in the right-of-way pending the indemnification agreement, and that motion was seconded by Mr. Gwaltney. The committee voted 4-0 to approve that.
All right, thank you. We have a motion from special issues. Do we have any other discussion or questions? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? And that is unanimous, and that is 1724. Thank you. 040117, request for consideration to add lighting to the traffic roundabout by All Saints Church, requested by Jason Kellen, Barry Smith, and the Finance Committee. We need a report from special issues. Ms. Smith.
Well, we voted to approve putting us one additional streetlight circling the roundabout at that location, and then we sent it to Finance for approval of the funding. And let's see. Do you have the motion? Ms. Andrews made the motion, and it was seconded by Mr. Gwaltney, and the committee voted 4-0 to send it to Finance for approval of funding.
All right, so we will refer this to Finance on committee referral, Mr. Jones.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. All right, we'll move on to 140117, request for consideration for permission to work in the city right-of-way at 1926 29th Avenue South, requested by Roy Cornelius, Greg Cobb, our BEZ department. Report from special issues, Ms. Smith.
Yes. Okay, sorry, I'm losing my place.
Take your time.
Sorry, I've got a lot of items on here. Okay, 1401 17, is that where we are? Okay, sorry about that. Okay, we met as again on February 6th, and we voted 4-0 to recommend the approval of the landscaping, with the motion being made by Ms. Andrews, seconded by Mr. Gwaltney. Voted 4-0, and we voted to approve that. Is that correct, or do I have the wrong thing?
Yes, this one doesn't involve landscaping. What okay. It did, they were going to plant two trees. They're going to put two trees
They're
back.
They're going to put two trees. Yeah. This is the big bad breakfast.
Yes, ma'am, and
yes,
we wanted to refer to Berkeley as type of species
right.
of trees.
To make sure that they had the right tree yes. selected and...
Right, and we deferred that to Berkeley.
Right, but yeah. otherwise we approved.
Yes,
we approved
ma'am.
The closing of the right of way for their during their construction. Yes,
and that's the indemnification agreement.
It
yeah.
is.
Okay.
It's subject to approval of the city on the tree.
I'll have this signed and get with Berkeley before anything proceeds.
Right. Yeah.
Are there any other comments that you might want to add, Mr. Cobb?
Well, what they're doing is some foundation and some fascia work to that building. For the safety of the public, we wanted to go ahead and close the sidewalk because, with them working on the fascia of that building, any bricks or anything that come off of there. So
sure.
The safest thing to do is just close it in that one section only. And there's not much traffic there except to the bank, and the easiest way to go on the bank's the backside anyway. So it's not going to be very detrimental. I think he said 5 weeks at the most.
Into May 1st.
He put into May 1st. That's right. We picked a date. Sure did.
There we go. any other questions of Mr. Cobb from council? If not, we've got a motion from special issues. So therefore, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So resolution 1725 is unanimous. Thank you, sir. 150117, public hearing set for tonight, February 13th at 6 p.m. for consideration of variance to the signed ordinance at 3450 Independence Drive, requested by D. Mantione.
I'm not quite sure. She's okay. Not here tonight. Are you here for her?
Greg Cobb.
Okay,
did
good.
I pronounce your name correctly?
Well, that's not my name.
She's not D.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you're here for them. Okay.
Yes.
Greg Cobb in the BEZ department. Let me begin, if I can, with a report from special issues.
And I actually know this one. We met on February 6th, and we voted to send this out to full council 4-0, pending the public hearing tonight. And that motion was made by Ms. Anders, seconded by Mr. Higginbotham, and again, 4-0, just pending the public hearing.
Sure. Well, let me start by opening the public hearing. And comments. You are?
I'm Deetra Underwood, representing Resource Residential. And the reason why we're wanting the sign to be bigger is because when people cross those two hills that come across those two hills, we won't be able to see the sign visibly. And the size that we have, the building is so big to where the size of the sign it's not visible from those two hills coming across and then from the road.
Okay. Any questions?
I will say, when we met last week during the committee meeting, several members of the committee expressed concern about the size of the sign because it's dramatically over what our typical allowed building face sign is, and also the fact that it was lit. We were a little bit hesitant with the lighting part of it as well.
Okay.
And I think y'all do have a monument sign on the property. Is that correct?
Yes.
There's an existing monument sign. And I know that doesn't give you all the visibility
right.
from the road that you want.
Right.
But I think there were some concerns from the committee on the lighting part of it and then just the general. And I know that portion of the building is large.
Mm-hmm.
But the size of it, where it is a little bit, and then the lighting part was a concern.
Okay.
Do we have a rendering of it?
I thought it was going to be up there.
I don't mean to put pressure on our...
Oh, there it is.
There it is. Okay.
Oh,
thank you.
I knew he would come
perfect.
Through.
I mean, it looks okay. I mean, it looks a lot nicer than I thought it was going to look. I think we were concerned because it was going from 49 feet to 96 feet.
Yeah.
That's a huge jump.
Well, from what I understand, they wanted only 20 extra square feet to make it 70.
Oh, okay. Because we heard 96.
As of last week, they were saying 96. Right, 90. Yeah.
90 or 96. Yeah. Was last week.
But
I talked to Dee about that on one day last week. I don't know. But anyway, I talked to Dee, the other Dee, in Atlanta about that last week and said you're going to have to bring it down.
This one says 70.
That one says 70?
At the bottom? Make sure I'm looking.
Yes. But if you, I think.
I don't know. I'm just reading what's on here.
Well, that's what it says, but I don't think it calculates that away. Because we'll find out right quick.
We can limit it to 70.
You can.
Is the image we just saw, does that represent 70 or 90?
Well, at the bottom it is 70. 70.30 square feet, single face.
Mr. President.
Yes.
Wait
just a second. Yes,
I was
Mr. Jones.
Ms. Underwood, are you okay with the 70.3?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
We're good with 70.3.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, then we don't. Well, we can just limit it to 70.3.
But what I'm saying is, what they're showing is 70 is really 90 because they don't calculate like I do.
So we'll use Mr. Cobb's calculations.
What the sign people? It calculates 90. It's 56 inches tall. We count the whole, we draw a box around the whole thing.
And so that's what she told me, it's 56 inches tall, because they don't have the space in between the letters in there. So what Mr. Kendrick's got is the same thing we've got. It's correct, and other that their calculation is not the way we do it.
The way you do it takes in the blanks, is that what you're saying?
Yes, sir. I just draw a rectangle around that thing.
I understand.
Yes, sir. And that's why we do them all.
Okay.
You'd have to take it into your calculation?
Yes. That's what I wanted to make sure everybody understands. So 70
is just the writing. It would be 90 if you take in the entire image.
That's the way we calculate, yes, sir.
Okay, well then I'm
Are those individual letters? I mean, is it like, are they individual letters? And then what were the red and the blue little lines that were underneath there?
It's just lines, little cursive underlines.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
The
blue and the red, what is that?
That's what I think Mr. Cox said.
Oh, that's okay.
They're not taking into account that. They're just doing the top set of letters and the bottom set of letters.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Okay.
They're making three measurements on that thing, and it's each line, but then you got to take the space in between to get the total height.
Right, and I'm asking, are those colors? I mean, is that going to be, like, I kind of prefer it without the colors. Are those lights? Is that fluorescent lighting?
Is it lit up red and blue? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
This is showing electrical. I don't know, is it the whole thing electric? But it shows electrical on the piece. Mm-hmm.
The comment or the call out on the right hand side says front lit LED channel letters 9-inch raceways on the brickwork.
It's all lit.
Mr. Cobb, how far from the street does the building sit? Do we know?
I wish I had measured that. It's at least 200 feet.
That's pretty good.
I can get you an accurate measurement, but I don't have it with me.
All right. Are there any other questions of these two individuals?
Yeah. Is the entire thing lit, or is it just part of it that's lit?
It shows it all lit separately.
But that isn't a part of the variance?
We don't have to have a variance on lighting, just on size.
It's good to know. Anyone else? All right, thank you both. Is there anyone else here who would like to speak to this matter, either for or against? If there is not, then we will close the public hearing and get any and all comments from our council. Who wishes to speak?
Well, I will say, I certainly don't want to prevent them from being able to be visible to people, the traffic going by. I get that. And they are off the road quite a bit. I mean, I know that too. But I would want to make sure that if we approve this, we approve it in a size that's more fitting, I think, than the 96 inches. That's really large to me, especially when it's lit up. So I would like, if we decide to approve it, I would like to approve it based on the calculations done by Mr. Cobb, and make sure that the sign stays within that actual 70 inches as opposed to the 96.
Well, the 70 inches is the lettering, the 90 inches
right.
is the...
But they would have to figure that out with their sign company, would be my suggestion.
You shrink it proportionally.
Yeah, you would...
Okay, is that your motion?
I would make that motion. I would move to approve, but make sure that we limit the size of the sign to that 70.3 and have them adjust their sign accordingly.
All right, we have a motion by Ms. Smith. Do we have a second?
Second.
Okay, Mr. Watts, the second. Any further comments?
Mr. Chair, I'm sorry. I just had a quick question. What size would the sign have to be within our current?
50.
Okay, I just wanted to be clear
about
that.
I have a question too.
Mr. Wright?
So in regard to the 70-90 thing we're talking about here, if we took the same sign and the underlying LED lighting was removed, would that change the measurement to where it's a 70, or would it still be a 90?
No, sir, it would not change it.
Okay. Okay.
Well, we have a motion and a second. Any other comments?
I would like it better without the...
I know.
Yes, please.
Mayor,
I was just gonna ask. You said it's how far off the road?
About 200 feet.
It's a good distance.
So we're talking two-thirds of football field.
Yeah, but it's a bright white
background.
That's
just an estimate.
Yeah,
I don't know if it's 200 feet off the road.
You don't think the purpose of a sign is... You can park...
Maybe 125 feet off the road.
Wait a minute, one at a time, please.
Oh, he's got it.
That looks a lot. No, it's probably 125 feet off the road.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, we have a motion in a second. Any other final comments?
Yeah.
All right, if there are not, all in favor, please say aye to this.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
All right, well, let's do a roll call.
Thank you. Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham?
No.
Mr. Wolverton?
No.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andress?
No.
Mr. Wright?
No.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes, so it passes 7-4. This is resolution 1725.
That's at 70 square feet?
Oh, that's
yes.
Yes. Point 3? Okay.
Yes. All right, so we move on to 1601. Wait a minute, it's 1726. I'm sorry. My mistake. All right, 1601-17, a public hearing set for tonight for consideration of a variance to the driveway ordinance at 308 Ridge Drive, Sam Croft, Greg Cobb, our BEZ department. We'll again start with a report from special issues.
Yes, the committee met on the 6th, and we determined this is actually the homeowners want to put in a parking pad at the front of their property adjacent to the city street. So it's actually not their driveway. It's actually a separate parking pad. So we voted to send 4-0 out to council without recommendation pending the public hearing tonight. So, and I believe we have the homeowner here to tell us a little bit about his plan.
All right, thank you, Ms. Smith. First, let me open the public hearing, and we'll begin with comments. And you are?
Sam Croft.
Mr. Croft.
Yes, okay. Thank you guys for the time to come in and talk to you tonight. All I'd like to do is get permission to put a parking pad so my wife can get her car off the street. So that's what I'm in here asking for, is permission to do that.
I understand. Any other questions for Mr. Croft?
We did have a discussion in the committee meeting about the fact that since it is adjacent to the road, one of the other council people noted that it needed to be able to bear the weight of a garbage truck or any city vehicle.
Correct. Yes, ma'am.
And I did check with Berkeley Squires, and he said a loaded garbage truck is about 40 tons.
Okay.
So I don't know if that affects your plans, but 40 tons is a lot of weight.
That is.
So he did get back to me afterwards and let me know that that was the weight that a full truck is.
I did speak with the contractor about that. He and I have another meeting tomorrow to assure that. Okay. If it is a problem, is there some form that maybe I think I could fill out that if it does happen, the city would not be held liable for that?
Well, we're going to, because you're working in our right of way,
sure.
You'll sign an indemnification agreement, which is that exact thing.
Correct.
Basically saying, we'll allow you to do that, but the city's not liable if anything happens. And if we need to come back and take it back, we
sure.
can.
Not a problem.
So yes, that will be part of the,
okay.
part of the deal.
Any other questions of Mr. Croft? Okay. Thank you, sir. Mr.
Thanks
Cobb, any comments?
Thanks for your time.
Oh, no, sir.
All right. Is there anyone else here who would like to speak to this particular matter, either for or against? If not, we will close the public hearing. Wait for comments from the council.
A couple questions.
Mr. Wright, please.
I'm sorry I went at the committee meeting. I have to ask all these questions. But other parking arrangements on the property. Do we have other parking available?
They do have a driveway, but they're right on Ridge Road. And so it just allows them to make sure they can get all their cars out of the street. And I mean, they do have a driveway, but it's a smallish driveway.
Okay.
So
and what kind of materials are we using for the
tumbled paver?
Tumbled paver?
Yes, it'd be like in a herringbone pattern before we have picked out. They'll have a design to it.
It was very attractive.
Should it be aesthetically?
Yeah, it was very aesthetically pleasing.
Okay, and will that help? Because I know we've looked at this before.
Ms. Croft, can you come back, please?
And I'm sorry, I would have asked questions. I thought I was going to ask you questions or they were going to discuss it up here. I apologize, I didn't do it when you were up here.
We need the microphone.
Will that be, what do you call it, you know, permeated for the water to go through? And, I mean, are we going to space those, or?
They would not be spaced, no, sir.
Would not be, okay.
There will be a grout between them, is the plan right now.
Okay.
And part of that is because of the need to...
Make it strong enough.
Make it strong enough to bear that weight, right.
All right. Those are all the questions I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wright. Any other questions? Mr. McCluskey?
Yes. Again, I was not at the committee meeting either. Do we happen to have a, was there a rendering done that we have here?
Do you have one? Yes, I'm sorry. It's kind of rough, but...
There was the actual paper.
Anyone else needs to see this?
This is Ridge.
Yes, sir.
And then this is the driveway that goes all the way to the back of the house.
Yes, sir.
Does anybody else want to look at this?
Good. We're good. Thank you, sir. All right, anyone else that wants to speak to this matter? If there is not, we will close this public hearing. And welcome a motion and a second from the council.
I would move to approve pending the proper indemnification agreement.
All right, we have a motion from Ms. Smith. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second from Mr. Gwaltney. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So resolution 1727 is also passed unanimously. And thank you, folks. Appreciate it. 170117, request for consideration to close Oak Grove Road between Raleigh Avenue and Hall Avenue for the West Homewood Street Festival, or Fest, on May 13th, 2017, from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m., requested by one Justin Limbaugh and Andrew Wolverton. And welcome a report from Public Safety, Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, Mr. President. The committee met and voted 4-0 to recommend this approval. The motion was made by Mr. Wolverton, seconded by Mrs. Andrews.
All right, so we have a motion for approval from Public Safety. Any other comments? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? And that is resolution 1728, and that is passed by all council members. All right, 180117, request to consider the levy of sales tax in the police jurisdiction, requested by Melody Salter, our finance director. Report from finance, Mr. Jones.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. The committee met, voted 4-0 to recommend amending ordinance 1270. Per Mr. Kendrick, and so this would be an ordinance to amend ordinance 1270.
Well, it's really more than that. It's an ordinance to amend ordinance 1270, ordinance 1866, and ordinance 2036, all previously adopted by the City Council, which assess an additional privilege, license, or excise tax as defined in each of those ordinances, and to provide for the effective date of the ordinance. Whereas the City Council has determined that the City elects not to assess privilege, license, or excise tests assessed by the ordinances within the police jurisdiction. Now, therefore, be it ordained by the City Council that the City Council does by the adoption resolution, delete in its entirety Section 2 of Ordinance 1270, 1866, and Ordinance 2036, Section 2's entitled Levy of Tax in Police Jurisdiction, so as to have the effect of not assessing the additional privilege and license tax in the police jurisdiction. Section 2, that by the adoption of this ordinance, the City elects not to collect privilege and license tax assessed by the three ordinances within the police jurisdiction. Section 3, that Council does by the adoption of the resolution assess the tax rate for the taxes assessed by the taxing ordinance within the police jurisdiction as a rate of zero. And then all Section 4, all other provisions of the taxing ordinances to remain in full force and effect other than the deletion of Section 2 in each of the ordinances. Section 5, that the ordinance shall become effective immediately upon its adoption by the City Council or publication as required by law.
Thank you, Mr. Kendrick. Chair would welcome a motion and a second for unanimous consent.
So moved.
Motion from Mr. McCluskey, second from Mr. Wright.
Yes.
Roll call, Ms. Salter.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham?
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton?
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andress?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. So, Chair would welcome a motion for adoption of ordinance number 2648.
Mr. President, can I just, I'm sorry again. Is this just to, we can apply sales taxes?
No, it's to pacify the Department of Revenue. We had an issue that we didn't collect sales taxes because the Supreme Court said about 10 years ago that we can only collect sales taxes in a police jurisdiction to the extent of the cost of services with the budget. It's impossible to account for that. So all cities throughout the state really quit assessing sales tax unless there's a specific methodology they come with to provide for the accounting. Because you can only collect taxes to the extent you have service costs in that area.
Okay.
And we really essentially have police jurisdiction. We're surrounded by all cities. It's a lot to do about nothing, to be honest.
Okay. That's a sufficient explanation for me. Thank you, Mr. Kendrick.
Were you my second on this?
I'll be your second.
Thank you. Okay. All right, roll call, Ms. Salter.
I'm sorry, who was the first on unanimous consent? I mean, on approve.
I'll be the first.
Mr. Thames is the first. Thames. You are the second. Thank you.
Thames and Wright, okay.
No, obviously not.
Okay, Thames and Wright. Okay, Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham?
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton?
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andress?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. So 2648 is passed unanimously. We move on to 200117, request for consideration of an ABC 040 retail beer on and off premises and 060 retail table wine on and off premises for Triple Dynasty LLC doing business as Black Pearl Asian Cuisine located at 180 State Farm Parkway. Requested by the city clerk. Report from public safety, Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, sir. This, like I said, was carried over from the January 23rd meeting. We had already received letters from both police and fire, and there was some question as to the classification for this particular license. And after city clerk spoke with the ABC board, this was the one that they were supposed to have. So I would move as to having no objection to the issuance of the license.
All right, so we have a motion from public safety. If there are no other comments, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? And that passes without objection. 240117, request to accept LDOT project number NH0149, parentheses 501, planning, resurfacing, safety widening, loop detectors, guardrail end anchors, and permanent traffic stripe on SR 149 from 1021.57 south of SR 38, Highway 280, to Columbiana Road, and to authorize the mayor to sign the contract. Greg Cobb, our BEZ department, carried over from 123 of 17 because we had some questions. Mr. Cobb, give us a report.
Yes, sir. DOT used their standard agreement, and in that agreement it says that on the last page that we will take care of all the roads connecting to that road up to where their right of way intersects us, which is typical, and we normally do that. But this one involves Old Montgomery Highway, which we don't think we own, if I'm correct. Mr. Kendrick and I have talked about this before, so I called the DOT and said, we're not going to sign that agreement because that commits us to take care of Old Montgomery Highway, and it's not ours. And of course they told me it was again. I said, well, as soon as you send me the paperwork that shows us, then, so they're going to have to rewrite that last page, or they're going to have to come up with some paperwork that shows us owning that road.
You said this in 10 years and haven't been able to do that.
I know.
Well, then my fellow council members that were concerned about the cost of such a thing were, maybe that wasn't the exact reason to carry this over, but it was certainly a good reason not to approve it.
Yes, sir. It is real important, though, because there's a lot to be done on that road that we don't need to bear the cost of.
and Mr. Kendrick can elaborate on that at another, whenever you like, but that's the issue. If they'll rewrite it and take that little section out, then life is good. But we don't want to sign anything that commits us to working on Montgomery Highway. No. No, we couldn't stand that.
So where do we go from here? Mr. Kendrick, do you think we'll carry it over then?
I just call DOT back and tell them they're going to have to exclude that somehow, some way. But any other time, it's a normal agreement. It's just that one road that I happen to know about.
Well, we will carry it over for a time, but only for a time. So.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Cobb.
Yes, sir.
Please get in touch with him. All right, 250117, request for consideration of a crosswalk on the corner of Manhattan and Claremont, requested by Britt Thames. Report from Public Safety, Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, Mr. President. The committee met and voted 4-0 to recommend approval of the crosswalk near the church at the corner of Manhattan and Claremont. The motion was made by Mr. Thames, seconded by Mrs. Andrus.
All right, so we have a motion from Public Safety, or a report, and we'll begin with the reading by Mr. Kendrick.
It's an ordinance to provide for the installation of pedestrian crosswalks at the intersection of Claremont Lane and Manhattan Street. Be it ordained by the city as follows. Chief of Police shall be directed to install 2 pedestrian crosswalks across Claremont Drive and 2 pedestrian crosswalks across Manhattan Street at the intersection of Claremont Drive and Manhattan Street as directed by the Chief of Police. Section 2, that any person violating this ordinance shall be punished as provided by Section 1-8 of the Code of Ordinances. Section 3, that all ordinances or parts of ordinance contrary are hereby repealed. Section 4, if any part of provision or ordinance declared to be unconstitutional by a court of competent jurisdiction, such holding shall not affect the other provisions. Section 5 of the ordinance shall become effective immediately upon its adoption by the City Council.
Thank you, Mr. Kendrick. Chair would welcome a motion and a second for unanimous consent. Motion from Mr. McCluskey, second from Ms. Smith. Roll call, Ms. Salter.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Hickenbotham?
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Ms. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andrus?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. So, Chair would welcome a motion for adoption of ordinance number 2649. Motion by Mr. McCluskey, second by Ms. Smith. Roll call.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Hickenbotham?
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton?
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones?
Yes.
Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt?
Yes.
Mrs. Andrus?
Yes.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh?
Yes. So 2649 is approved by all. We'll move on to committee referral agenda. Chair would welcome a motion for approval.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. McCluskey, second by Ms. Andrus. Yeah, you sit on my right side, not my left side.
Second.
All right, thank you. Any further discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And that is unanimous. All right, so we move on to other new business, and we start with 010217, request to set a public hearing and referral to the Special Issues Committee for consideration of a variance to the sign ordinance at 230 Green Springs Highway, requested by Park Grimmer, Greg Cobb, and our BEZ department. Can we set that public hearing for 2 weeks, Mr. Kendrick?
Yes, sir. March 13th is the first time.
March 13th. Okay, well, that's a little further. But.
Well, I'm sorry. You could have it at the next meeting. I thought this was going to committee. I'm sorry.
Well, it's referred to special issues.
If you want to set the public hearing, I'm changing
it. Well, let's set it for February 27th then.
Okay,
thank you. 020217, request to set a public hearing and referral to the Special Issues for consideration of a variance to the sign ordinance at 1920 29th Avenue South, requested by John Bodner and Greg Cobb with our BEZ department, and we will set that one for 227 as well. All right, 030217, request to set a public hearing and referral to Special Issues for consideration of a variance to the fence ordinance at 123 Edgewood Boulevard, requested by Shea Vale, Greg Cobb, and our BEZ department. And since that's the last one we're going to set, we'll set that one for February 27th as well. That's only 3.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for handling it. All right, okay, 120217, request for consideration of an ABC 020 retail liquor license for Eat Cha Town Foods LLC, doing business as Vinnie Bags, located at 1006 Oxmoor Road. I ate there yesterday. Requested by the city clerk. Report from Public Safety, Mr. McCluskey.
Thank you, Mr. President. Background checks are done. Fire department has signed off as well, so I would move as to having no objection to the issuance of the license.
All right, so we have a motion from Public Safety.
Mr. Limbaugh, that actually didn't go to committee. It's on other new business. I think we're going to have to have a second.
Yeah, I'd second. I'd second that.
What? I'm sorry.
Need a second.
Yeah, I'll second it.
Okay, thank you. Okay, it didn't go to committee. I see. So we have a motion from Mr. McCluskey, second from Mr. Jones. Thank you all for keeping me straight. Mm-hmm. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
And that was unanimous. And that vote is approved. Okay, 130217, request for consideration of an ABC 020 restaurant retail liquor for H&H Eats LLC, doing business as Soho Social, located at 1830 29th Avenue South, Suite 120. Requested by the city clerk. Report from Public Safety.
Yes, Mr. President. We've also received letters from both police and fire to having no issuance, so I would move as to having no objection to the issuance of the license.
All right, so that is you as an individual, Mr. McCluskey?
Me as an individual.
I'll second that again.
And Mr. Jones would be the second. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Wait a minute, wait a second.
I'm sorry, I thought I heard Thames and then you said Jones. I was just looking at
No, McCluskey. No.
McCluskey Jones, okay.
McCluskey Jones, I'm sorry. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? And it is approved. All right, 140217, request for consideration of an ABC 040 retail beer on and off premises and 060 retail table wine on and off premises for Homewood Marketable LLC, doing business as Market Table. Okay. Well, one spelled M-A-R-K-E-T and one spelled M-A-K-E-T.
Sorry, a typo.
So I wasn't trying to catch you in a mistake there.
Sorry.
No problem. Market Table, located 1830 29th Avenue South, Suite 175. Report from Public Safety, Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, we have, for the third, or actually the fourth one of the night, we have received both letters from police and fire, and I would move individually as to having no objection to the issuance of the license.
Thank you, Mr. McCluskey. Do we have a second?
Second.
I'm still going to give it to Ms. Smith. Thank you very much. Okay. I know, but you have power, but she was more aggressive. All right. Any further discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
And that is unanimous as well. 150217, request for consideration of declaring the following city clerk finance department's furniture surplus property, large L-shaped office wood desk, two standard wooden office desk with four drawers, two drawer wooden filing cabinet, bear with me, two office desk with partitions and metal filing cabinets and drawers, laminate desk table with keyboard tray. Boy, this is a lot of details. Wooden round table with four upholstered conference armchairs.
I didn't have a VIN number, President Limbaugh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. Wooden credenza with drawers and sliding doors, wooden bookcase. I'm ignoring all of it. With three shelves and sliding doors. Wooden executive office desk with drawers. Wooden office desk with hutch. All listed by our city clerk. All right, Mr. Kendrick, you don't have to read all that since I did.
So you talk about me reading these ordinances.
Yes, sir. Well said.
Hereby establish and declare that the following described personal property of the city is no longer needed for public or municipal purposes, and the property has been adequately described by Mr. Limbaugh. Section 2, the mayor is authorized and directed to dispose of the property described in Section 1 by public auction to the highest bidder.
Thank you, Mr. Kendrick. Chair would welcome a motion.
Move for unanimous consent.
Second.
Motion from Mr. Jones, second from Mr. McCluskey. Roll call, please, ma'am.
Let me correct that. I've just been told by the clerk that we're going to not auction it. We're going to trade it in on purchase of furniture.
Do we still need an ordinance for that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, we have the motion and the second.
Yes, sir, just modify what I read. Will not be by public to the highest bid, it would be trade-in on exist, on purchase of furniture.
All right.
I accept that.
Thank you. Again, Jones McCluskey.
Okay, Mr. Waltney.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham.
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones.
Yes.
Mrs. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt.
Yes.
Mrs. Andress.
Yes.
Mr. Wright.
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh.
Yes. This will be ordinance 2650, and chair would welcome a motion for adoption of said ordinance.
So moved.
Motion by Ms. Smith, second by Mr. Higginbotham. Thank you. Roll call, please, ma'am.
Mr. Gwaltney.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Thames.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Higginbotham.
Yes.
Mr. Wolverton.
Yes.
Mr. McCluskey.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Jones.
Yes.
Mrs. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Wyatt.
Yes.
Mrs. Andress.
Yes.
Mr. Wright.
Yes.
And Mr. Limbaugh.
Yes. So ordinance 2650 is passed by all. We'll move on to 160217. Request for consideration to authorize the mayor to sign contract with Brunson White for IT assessment and fund as per the fiscal year 16-17 general fund budget requested by Walter Jones, Melody Salter, our finance director, and let's see. So we don't need a report. Therefore, chair would welcome a motion and a second.
I would move for it. It's budgeted, so we're just requesting that be signed by the mayor.
Second.
Well, do we need a resolution in that case, Mr.
Yes,
Kennedy?
Yes, you have one.
Yeah, we have one.
Okay. Motion by Mr. Jones, second by? Mr. Gwaltney beat you. Thank you.
A resolution.
That'll be resolution 17. Hold on. Help me.
1729.
Great. Yes. All right. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? That is unanimous. Finally, we get to 170217, request for consideration of approval of vouchers for a period of January 23rd through February 12th, 2017. Mr. Jones.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. I yield the floor to Mr. Higginbotham, who worked very hard on this week.
Mr. Higginbotham.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would move the item with the addition of two things that came in late, tuition reimbursement for Mr. Boyd and Homewood Fire and Rescue, and payment of appraisal for the property on 26th Avenue.
All right, thank you. So,
And Mr. President, that's a motion from the floor, and I'll second that.
I understand. Thank you very much. Any other discussion? There being none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? That is resolution 1730. Thank you very much, Mr. Higginbotham. And we move to that point in our meeting when we welcome comments from our mayor.
Thank you, Mr. President. First of all, I do want to recognize and thank you and the council for taking a second to I have a moment of silence for the former mayor. As you know, he did a lot of great things for our city, served on the council for, I think, 8 years. His mayor is 12. So as we discussed today, I'm sure as we'll let some time pass for the family, but hopefully be able to get maybe them here to formally recognize and appreciate his years of service to the family. So I do think it's important that we do that. And then on a lighter note, JJ wanted to make sure that I announced to you that on February the 20th, City Hall is closed for President's Day.
Woohoo!
And then just a couple other dates. You'll hear more as it gets a little closer, but to go ahead and at least get on your radar, I think the Exceptional Foundation's chili cook-off, I believe, is going to be on Saturday, March 4th at Brookwood Village, and then Taste of Homewood on March the 9th. So if you'll go ahead and mark your calendars, and hopefully we'll see you there. Thank you.
We love our food in Homewood, don't we, Mayor?
That's right. We've got a lot of great restaurants. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, well, then let's have a little discussion before I go down the proverbial road. Do we want to try to have committee meetings on the, it's going to be difficult on the 21st because I know Ward 1 has a town hall meeting, so. I'm trying to make this easier on you, Mr. Wright, seriously.
I don't feel it, but. Our meeting isn't until 6. That makes any difference. We could do, you know, it's just going to be hard to get them all in on that Monday, but if we could do some of them maybe on that Tuesday and some of them on that Monday.
Well, I think that's going to be the best solution, so I will leave you committee chairs to talk amongst yourself on that as we go through.
Mr. Lamar, I have one correction to make too. Earlier about the vacant position on the IDB, I said it was Stephen Johnson. It's Stephen Jones.
Yes.
Okay, I just wanted to make that for the
record. No. I should have corrected you, but I.
Okay.
You know I don't like to do that. Mr. Gwaltney?
I was going to mention our Ward 1 meeting at the Lee Center to discuss abatement at Rosedale, but since we've covered it, if any of you guys would like to attend, feel free. 6 p.m. at the Lee Center.
All right, thank you. Mr. Thames, could you have an earlier meeting for your committee?
Well, why don't I just roll mine to the 27th because we're discussing the traffic study, which we won't move out of committee into council anyways. So it would be simple to have it before council that day, maybe at 5 o'clock.
Do you need an hour?
No, but I figure there may be another committee or two after mine.
Okay. How much time do you need?
Probably 30 minutes because I'd like to have Kaz back. And in the meantime, the council think about sort of the scope of the project. As you recall, it's either we have two choices, either sort of a 10,000 foot view citywide, or we drill down to specific areas just basically to try and make the money go further. I don't know how much detail we'll get out of the 10,000 foot plan. So I think Kaz asked that maybe we think about our specific wards and specific areas in our wards, and maybe if we put that list together, that'll kind of give us an idea of which route we need to go. So, two weeks, think about that, 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock on the 27th, thank you.
Yes, sir, thank you.
Planning and development, by the way. Mr. Higginbotham?
Thank you, Mr. President. Ward 2 actually has a meeting on Thursday, but I'll let Andrew talk about that. I suppose most of us know that it was in September of 1926 when the communities of Rosedale, Edgewood, and Grove Park voted to officially become the city of Homewood. But I just happened to cross this in a book the other day, and so I made a note of it. Actually, it was February 11th, this last Saturday, that we were officially recognized as a new city by the state of Alabama. So that would have been our 90-year anniversary of being officially recognized as a city by the state of Alabama. I feel confident that's why our local news reporter, Sydney Cromwell, had her wedding on Saturday, was so that she could coincide with that auspicious occasion. She's not here tonight to benefit from that comment, but I had it in my back pocket. I had to use it. Anyway, we've come a long way in 90 years, and I suspect none of us will be here 90 years from now to talk about this, but someone will, and that's the beauty of having a municipality and a democratic government. So I did want to acknowledge it since I happened to run across it this week. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Higginbotham. Mr. Wolverton?
Yes, so just a few things as Mike touched on. We are having a West Homewood meeting Thursday evening at Raleigh Avenue Baptist Church at 6:30. Just kind of set up to inform our constituents about what's going on and what's where we know things are currently with any plans citywide or ward-wide. I wanted to thank the Homewood Police Department for letting me ride along three times so far. I did really enjoy it. I think it gives you a great perspective on what they do, especially in the middle of the night. I'm going to try and do some other times as well, but I appreciate them letting me do that, and gives you a newfound appreciation for what they do for us every day. The Bell Center just had one of their biggest fundraisers of the year with the Mercedes Marathon. So I just wanted to kind of recognize them. They are a Homewood staple. They've been here 33-plus years now. Founding director, Betty Bell's sweet old 80-something-year-old lady that still runs around with her rollator and visits kids in the hospital and does a lot of great things for Homewood. And they talked about, I didn't realize this, but they had at one point looked at moving outside of Homewood and have since decided they are staying, but they have to renovate the space that they're in. So hopefully we can all kind of find a time to get together and kind of see a little bit about what they do. Obviously, in my line of work, I understand what they do, but it's just a cool thing that they've got going on here for us and the greater Birmingham area. And then lastly, I'm going to make another plug for the Wine 10K, which is in Homewood. In March 11th. You can come on the 10th. You'll be there early. So anybody that hasn't signed up that wants to, it'll be a fun event, and looking forward to it.
Thank you, sir. Mr. McCluskey?
Yes. I'll set public safety for the 27th at 5:30. You said you only need 30 minutes, right, Brett?
Yep.
All right, and I'll only need 15 to be able to cover everything I need. And then 3 weeks from tomorrow is the Exceptional Foundation basketball game, which really is like one of my favorite event of the year. So I expect JJ to be dressed this year.
You Mr. Bischoff, we need a commitment.
You better dress out.
Right? We need a commitment.
And that means, Peter, you have 3 weeks to
perfect. I need your uniform size from everybody now.
Perfect that shot.
The dunk behind the back. We need, to take them down the this year, okay? All right.
You're kidding, right?
About 15 minutes before game time.
It's on your sofa in your head.
All right. Good call. That would be a good thing, Mayor. Mr. Jones, could you have your meeting on the 21st? That would be a good thing.
Sure, but we really only have two items, so we only need about 15 minutes. But we can have it on the 21st at 6 o'clock. That's fine.
Well, that's their
5:30.
Yeah. Okay.
5:30, finance on the 21st. That works fine. And I want to thank Brian Wallace for the new system we have. It's going to take some getting used to, but I appreciate the professionalism that he's brought to the chamber here, and I just think it's going to be great. We're just going to have to get used to it, and see everybody's looking up there now. So, but anyway, thank you, Brian, for all your work on that. Prayers out to the McCulley family, and I'm missing my son's basketball game, so I'm going to leave shortly here. They're up 12-2 after the first quarter. So,
Mr. Jones, you are excused.
Thank you.
Ms. Smith?
I am going to, since we have some public hearings about special issues on the 27th, I'm going to set my meeting actually before Walter's. You said 5:30?
5:30.
Okay. I think we can probably knock it out in 15 minutes, so I'm going to say 5:15 on the 21st for special issues.
All right. Thank you.
You had like 9 items that were added on.
Oh gosh, that's right.
just point it
no,
out.
No, you're so right.
So could we make it 5 o'clock?
Let me make it 5 o'clock instead of 5:15, and that'll give us 30 minutes. That should give us enough time. And then let me also say, for those of you, I hope you got downstairs to to see the Bristlecone Project exhibit that was in the lobby. It's gone now. I want to thank Diane Litzy and the Arts Council because they did help them get that exhibit up and down. They gave them a lot of help, a lot of guidance, and it was really a moving exhibit. I hope everybody had a chance to look at it. And I just want to say that the guy, Jason, who was kind of in charge of it and has the 30 is 30 organization, the man who abused him, who was in here, was a Homewood person, his parole is coming up on March 15th, and they are asking people to write letters in opposition to his parole. So if anybody's interested in doing that, let me know. I have the address to send it to the Pardons and Paroles Board. You don't get a lot of shout outs for wrestling, So my son is on the Homewood High School wrestling team, and they qualified 10 wrestlers to go to the state tournament this weekend in Huntsville with one champion of his division, his weight class. So just good luck to all the wrestlers who will be competing in Huntsville this weekend, including my son who qualified for state. So
absolutely.
Little shout out for him too.
Thank you, Ms. Smith. We agree. Mr. Watt?
To continue that about the high school athletics, congratulations to the indoor track boys and girls teams. The girls won state again for some time, something in a row. I'm not sure what the streak is at. Yeah. And the boys came in second, and the girls basketball team won their area. So congratulations to all of them. And I second the wrestling team. They don't get a lot of press, but they do a really good job. So good luck to them at state.
Thank you, Mr. Wyatt. Ms. Andrews?
And to add on to Mr. Wyatt's, I want to say congratulations to Laney Phelps for Gatorade Athlete of the Year, and Will Stone also for Gatorade Athlete of the Year male. Mr. Wright and I had a really great meeting with Tom Thagard, who's the president of the Kiwanis Club, and he brought us up to speed on what the project they're doing at Vulcan Park is. It looks fantastic. They're about to put $4 million into the park, and they have a really neat lighting display coming up. And a trail, of course. They're going to improve the trail that's up there and connect eventually down to our sidewalks that we'll have on Valley. And anyway, it's a great meeting and exciting things coming. So,
great. Thank you, Mr.
And we'll hear more about that. A couple things. Thanks to Brian Wallace, as Walter said, for getting us up to date technologically and video-wise, and look forward, and Linda, I get to look at myself, so what a wonderful treat. A couple other, I'm a little partial to our show choir, so I'll get a quick show choir update. Our high school show choir team is just knocking it out. They just swept everything this weekend for the high school. I'm particularly partial to the middle school. We didn't do quite as good, but we got third place. We've had a couple of second places and numerous awards, and it's really a treat as a parent and a treat to have that as part of our curriculum in our education system, bringing up those middle schoolers to go through that experience in high school. So congratulations to all those teams. Also, just a quick update. As a school liaison, we have received our bids today from our construction companies for our big task force for our $110 million projects going forward, and we look forward to looking at those and reporting back. And I just want to let the council and the city know we've received those, and we'll have more meetings with the task force and hopefully some selections. We're hoping within about a 2-week period here, so that we will know who's going to be doing this work and hopefully some plans soon thereafter going forward. And lastly, I have to set a meeting.
Yes.
I have one item. What do we have on the 27th right now?
We have a 5:00 for P&D for 30 minutes and public safety at 5:30 for 30 minutes.
No,
15 minutes.
All right, then I can do 5:45.
You could do 5:45.
Excuse me, because I just have one item.
All
okay,
right.
Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Those of you who are on the task force, you have literally that much reading to do. So if you read until 2 or 3 a.m., I'm not going to feel sorry for you, because I'll be right there with you. With that, thank you very much for everyone's involvement, and we'll stand adjourned. Thanks.